What's up, everyone? It's TK here, TK Doris Clark, with a channel update. As you can see, we're going to be doing some rambling as well, but I'm going to get the channel update part out of the way first, so those who don't want to hear it, y'all can skip that, I guess. But if you're on lunch break, or if you're at school and you're bored, you know, that rambling part might be just for you. Alright, so the channel update, returning back to YouTube, or how knows long, I don't know. But I just feel like doing YouTube now, and we're gonna be back at it. So, as you probably noticed, if you've been looking on YouTube and subscriptions thing, you can see I've been live streaming a lot recently. So that's what's gonna be happening. I'll be live streaming more on YouTube. So come in, feel free to say what's up. Maybe do some multiplayer reaction as well. Uncharted. That's the only game I play online, no, really, to be honest. Fortnite. I tried messing with Fortnite. I'm not really too into it. It get boring fast, you know what I'm saying, to me. But, yeah. So, we're gonna be streaming a lot more on YouTube. More discussion videos. Trailer reactions, of course, like I always have been doing. And I might start doing episode reactions to animes, you know what I'm saying? And I think I mentioned that on one of my older trailer reactions, but I didn't have the program working right. But now I got it working right, so I could definitely do it. And I already tested it out, and it looks like it's going to work just fine. So, that's what's coming to the channel. Now, what have I been up to? Pretty much what I've always been up to. I've been playing games, been watching anime, and I've been streaming. But I was streaming on YouTube. And as you can see, I never stop really uploading videos when I was kind of going on YouTube, because I was uploading like stuff that I was streaming on Twitch. Like, I would just upload that stream to YouTube. The last videos I actually uploaded was like review videos, and I did a trailer reaction as well. Trailer reaction. But it wasn't like the video trailer reaction, it was just me just sitting on camera reacting because my mouse was broken. But I got a new mouse now, so we all good. So, if you haven't already, go check out those last four videos I did. Dragon Ball Super anime review. I did Dragon Ball FighterZ video game review. Did the God of War video game review, and I did the Kingdom Hearts. I think it was the Toy Story one, or I think they had another one after the Toy Story one. I think it was that one, whichever one. I forgot what it was on. But that last trailer was lit. It was lit, and I think it's coming out this year for Rizzles. You know what I'm saying? But if you haven't already, go check those videos out. I kind of want to do a live E3 stream, but I'm not sure my computer can handle me streaming my face in the web browser thing, because I tried before on Twitch. I was just trying to do like IRL type stream, and it was super laggy. So I might, if I do one of those, I might just make it like in the podcast form or something, and we just kind of just, we are watching it, but like you watch it on your own, like TV or computer, and I'll be watching my own separate thing, so it'll just be a face cam or Google icons, and we just, them just talking about it, whatnot, reacting and stuff like that. So I'm thinking about doing something like that. E3 is next month, so it's gonna be lit, hopefully. Don't really got my expectations up for E3 though, to be honest. I am hoping to see some more good games from PlayStation, because that's what I'm rocking right now. My 3DS is dead. I need a 2DS. I only want like 3 games on 3DS, to be honest. I never got the Pokemon Sun and Moon, I never got Fire Emblem Echoes, and I never got that Dragon Ball Z game that I did trash on a while back. And that's when my freaking DS started to stupid. Like, I turn on, everything just start moving, and I'm not moving the analog stick or nothing. I try moving the analog stick to stop it. It don't want to stop, so yeah. But I do want to get a Nintendo Switch. They got a Shin Megami game coming out on the Nintendo Switch, and I want them to. I'm not sure if they ported it or not, but I want that Tokyo Mirage on the Switch as well. So there's a couple of RPGs on Switch that I want to get my hands on. In that Pokemon, which we don't know what type of Pokemon game it is. Everyone's assuming it's going to be a Pokemon game like Sun and Moon, But Nintendo still say they're gonna support the 3DS. So it might not be a Pokemon, that type of Pokemon game everyone's expecting on the Switch. But I still want one for the RPGs, my JRPGs. Shout out to my people in Japan. Shout out to all the Japanese people, because y'all got all the, y'all make all the greatest creations. All the greatest creations. It's all the great, I mean, it's all, I say it's all the greatest creation. They got all the greatest creation because that's pretty much what I'm messing with 24/7. Japanese stuff. I'm playing Japanese games. I'm freaking watching Japanese shows. Listening to Japanese music. Well, I haven't listened to Japanese music in a while, but yeah. Shout out to Japan. So yeah, that's pretty much, I kind of rambled on already pretty much, but we're gonna get into the more rambling on section. I already pretty much gave the what's coming to the YouTube. I think, oh yeah, Tokyo Game Show. Well, I think that's it in a year, I think. So besides me screaming on Twitch and stuff, I've been of course watching anime. Probably been watching more anime than I have last year. I think I have been watching more anime than last year at this moment. I pulled off a couple of marathons this year. I did the Fairy Tail marathon, watched all the Fairy Tail episodes. I watched some of it a couple years back because someone recommended it to me, and I stopped watching it. Then I decided to come back to it because I wanted to give it a second try. So, and I actually really like Fairy Tail because the fights were not long. And just because how it is, the characters, the little comic in it, the comedy type stuff that's inside of it, like it's nice and chill. It's probably was on like two or three things in it that was like that made it that kind of dragged on. Besides that, it's like the fight scenes not really that intense or long and stuff like that. So I like it. I did the Yu Yu Hakusho marathon. A little bit after I watched Fairy Tail, what else did I do marathon on? Then I was only to a marathon on. That's like has over 50 episodes. But yeah, since talking about anime, I got my anime list thing up. Guess try to skim through the list, I guess. So this is this current stuff I'm watching. Two of the things I'm not actually watching. I never changed it to my plan to watch list. But My Hero Academia Season 3 is starting to pick up. It's finally starting to pick up. Because after Season 1, the end of Season 1, I was kind of excited to see what was going to happen to that. But it was just straight chill. It never really kind of picked up until the end of Season 2. And then it was still not really nothing interesting to me like that, really. And then the last two episodes, it got me. I had the feels, not the Naruto feels, not close to Naruto feels, but I had some feels when Midoriya was fighting that villain trying to protect that boy. And Boruto, you already know I'm watching the Boruto. Like, I'm never stopping watching the Boruto, the Naruto though. So yeah, really enjoying the Boruto. They are now at the point of the movie when and Boruto is taking the Chunin's nails, but he's not in the fighting part. They're at the part when they're doing like the first couple of rounds first when they do other stuff before they actually fight. So really enjoying Boruto. High School DxD, I'm actually putting this on hold because I haven't watched it in so many years since it's been. I don't like when animes do that. Like, when this first started, when I first started watching this, the High School DxD anime, I watched it when season 3 was just finished come out. So I watched season 1, then I watched season 2, I watched the OVAs and stuff like that, then season 3 was coming out right around there, so there was no break, so I was really into this series, you know, and now I'm like, what the heck is going on? But I'm still gonna watch it, whatnot, and Blue Exorcist, that happened to me with Blue Exorcist. Watched first two seasons, then years passed, and they brought a new one recently, and I'm like, I don't know what the heck is going on. I was googling trying to see if they put out like a recap episode or something, so I could just watch that. Cause I ain't really trying to go back in and watch it, even though Blue Exorcist is a good anime, but I just didn't feel like watching it. I got way too much other anime to watch. So yeah, High School DxD is on hold. I'm waiting for all the dubs to come out. This one is Bed and Breakfast for Spirits. That's pretty much what the English title would be, something like that. A real nice chill anime, pretty much about a girl who can see spirits, and she ends up going to this spirit realm. I mean, that the spirit world, pretty much, and she found out her freaking uncle. I mean, not uncle, her freaking grandpa had her in his debt. Like, if he didn't pay back the guy, then his granddaughter would marry this guy and whatnot. And so she's pretty much trying to pay off the debts because she don't want to be this orc's wife. Very nice art style though. Very nice, cutesy, kawaii art style in the anime though. Really enjoying it. Then we got Persona 5. You already know how I feel about Persona 5. I played the game. I mean, I beat the game twice. I'm actually gonna go back and beat it again, but I've just been holding off because I don't know what I'm gonna play after I beat it. I need to get me another game before I decide to go back and play and beat Persona 5 two, three, four, five more of the time, just because I like the storyline, I like the characters, I like everything about it, man. But anime is, of course, a condensed version of the actual video game. They're trying to get everything into it just to pretty much summarize it. If y'all watched the Persona animes in the past, it's nothing special. They're just trying to summarize the video game. So I highly recommend you play the actual video game before you actually watch the anime. Pokemon Sun and Moon. Pokemon, I'm binge watching episodes. The episodes pile up. I prefer the English version. Kind of like Karen Ash's voice. Just like Naruto, I prefer listening to Naruto's voice and some of the other characters' voices. Because like when I watch anime, I do voices in my head. Every single anime, I do a certain voice in my head for a character. It's a boy character, we're going to do this type of voice. It's a girl character, we're going to do a type of voice for it. I don't know if everyone else do that, but I make voices for characters when I watch subs, and I refuse to do that for Pokemon, and I refuse to do that for Naruto. But I did end up watching the sub episodes for Naruto before Naruto came out, because I didn't want to be behind on the Boruto. And I pretty much knew anyone's voices, so I could just do it in my head with ease and read it with ease as well. So yeah, we got Food Wars Season 3, I believe. Very good anime. Maybe have some very nice, delicious looking foods on there. And anime is pretty good. When I started watching Food Wars, I always used to see the realm. But Food Wars is lit. The first season, the second season, this season is starting to pick up, but it's a very good anime. Really, really enjoyable anime, man. Y'all gotta check that out. Sora Online, Alternate Gun Guild Online. This is the gun world, the gun video game world. This one is starting a girl character. I mean, only watched one episode, as you can see. This one is actually on hold for me. I'm waiting for episodes to pile up. I just kind of bench watch that. But I really enjoyed the first episode, so we're gonna get into that at a later time. Then we got Tokyo Ghoul, this is season 3. I hate how season 2 ended. And this season I'm completely confused what the heck is going on, but I'm still watching it. Tokyo Ghoul fanboys and fangirls are fanboys and girls, because you look at the rank for this freaking thing, this thing is like a freaking 9 or something. And the thing ain't even done complete. The thing ain't even completed. Now, as you can probably see, I did give Food Wars an 8, because, I mean, it's good, and I know it's not going to let me down. Gave Pokemon 7, being fair, you know, wait till they get finished. I get that 7, because it's pretty good so far, and, like, half episodes. This one got 26 episodes. I thought this only had 12 episodes. This thing got 26 episodes, okay, so it might go up or it might go down. Naruto, I know Naruto's one of my favorite movies, so I know it ain't going to disappoint me, so I already gave it a score. But come on, these people was giving Tokyo Ghoul. All my anime things. But these people giving Tokyo Ghoul 9 and stuff. Knowing God dang well, ain't gonna be all that. Yeah. They be switching up on these other anime, you know what I'm saying? For instance, the end of episode 3, I think, of Tokyo Ghoul, they showed the girl from the other two. At the end of the freaking thing, I got so kind of hyped and excited. Next episode, they ain't showed nothing of that. I was like, really? You just gonna do me like that? Yeah, that was wrong. They did me wrong. And then we got Virgo Eye, which is on hold as well. Something I just checked out randomly one day. Called the Anime to Watch. So yeah. And because I got other whole lot of other stuff I could be showing you about that in the day. It's gonna take like a freaking hour. Let's go all the way through that. But of course, TK with Oriscore is my name on the My Anime list. So go check me out. Go stalk what I'm watching, all that good stuff. But yeah. I think that's enough of rambling. I talk about what I was going to do. Let me turn the game on. That shit just went off on me. Get a power saving mode though. I'm actually in stream right now. But that's pretty much it. Yeah. Told you what I was going to do with the stream. I mean with the YouTube return. More discussion videos. More streams. Possible anime reaction videos. And I kind of want to do some live E3 stuff. So yeah. And I just rambled on to y'all about anime and video games that I've been messing with. Yeah, I think my first under it popped back onto YouTube. You just heard it slightly though. That Persona 5 background though, the Velvet Room with Augustine and Caroline, and you got the evil Igor. Oh, is that the oops, my bad. Okay, that's the spoiler. If I ain't played the song, I kind of just spoiled it for y'all. I ain't talk too much about it, but okay. So, yeah, that's going to be it for the video, for the live stream. I'll probably be streaming before this video gets uploaded, but depending on what time you watch, the stream might be over by then, but who knows. Anyways, I'm TK, TK with Oscar. Thanks for tuning in. Until next time, I'll see y'all later.